Hello friends, let's continue the exercise 7.4. So in the last video we have seen the first four questions of this exercise. Now in this video we'll be covering the remaining four questions. So the first question is the fifth one. So the maximization problem we have here. Okay, so let's have the question. Maximize the given objective function. So step number one, we will follow the same strategy. So z is equals to 3x plus 5y. Write down the non-negative constraints. So which is nothing but x plus 4y less than or equals to 24, 3x plus y less than or equals to 21, and x plus y is less than or equals to 9. You can check the origin availability in the solution set here itself. Okay. So don't worry, we will have this step, second step. Write down the non-negativity constraints as it is and convert them into the equations. X plus 4y is equals to 24. We have 3x plus y less than or equals to 21. So 3x plus y becomes 21. And finally, we have x plus y less than or equals to 9 becomes x plus y equals to 9. Okay, get the double intercept form. So it is x by 24. Plus y by 6 equals to 1. Sorry, so this becomes x plus 7 plus y by 3 so 1, and we have x by 9 plus y by 9, it is equals to 1. Okay, so it's a 6 into 4 is 24. That's great. Okay, so let's have this graph paper. Let's paste it. Let's have the y-axis and x-axis here. So y-axis and the x-axis goes here. Okay, so great. Okay, so let's name this. Now if you observe here, for the x-axis we have the intercept which is of 24. So let's have the 24. So we'll have the two units, so 2 4 8, so 2 bhi nahi chalega, ab to 3 lenge kya. So yes, we'll take 3 3 saha 9 12 3 5 15 18 3 8 24. So here we have it 24, and here we'll have 3 and 6 9 12 15 18 21 and 24. Okay, so let's plot the, so first line is nothing but 24 and 6. So here we have the 24 and here we'll have the 6. So draw the line which is passing through these two points. So this is what the line is which is passing through the point 24 and 6. So the equation is x plus 4y is equals to 24. X plus 4y equals to 24 equation. Second equation is 3x plus y equals to 21. So its intercepts are 7 and 3. Okay, let's take 7 here somewhere. Here we'll be having 7 and the 3. 7 and 3. Oh, sorry. We have here the y coefficient is 1, so here we will be having the 21, not 3. So here we will be having the 21. So the intercept, so will not get this line. So this line will be, so the y intercept is at 21. So here you will be having the point. Okay, so y is equals to 21. So now let's draw the point, draw the line which is passing through this 7 and 21. So this is the way you get the line. So it's passing through the 7 and 21. The equation of line is x plus, sorry, 3x plus y is equals to 21. It's 3x plus y, it is equals to 21. And the third line we have is x plus y is equals to 9. C means it will pass through the point 9 and 9. Okay, now let's draw the line again. So it is passing through the point 9 and 9. Okay, and the equation becomes x plus y, it is equals to 9. Now for all of these three, find out the feasible solution region individually. So the region becomes each and every inequation is less than, so definitely it is going to satisfy the 0-0 condition. So this condition is okay, this condition here also satisfied, here also satisfied, means what? We get below the lines the region, and this is what the common region for all of these three. And due to the non-negative constraints, we are bound in the first quadrant. So what are the corner points you will be having? So the first point is nothing but 0, 6. The second point here will be having B, we'll find out. We have the point C, we'll find out, and we have the point D, which is nothing but 6, 0, and finally we have the origin O, 0, 0. Now let's find out the value of B and C. So B is nothing but the intersection of x plus 4y equals to 24 and x plus y equals to 9. Okay, so for B, solve for B, which is nothing but the intersection of x plus 4y, it is equals to 24, and it is nothing but x plus y, it is equals to 9. So simply subtract the second equation from the first. So this xx will get cancelled. So I will be having 3y, it is equals to, so 24 minus 9 is nothing but 15. Okay, implies y is equals to how much? Y is equals to again 5. So substitute y is equals to 5 in any one of the equations. So x plus y is equals to 9. If y is 5, my x becomes 4. Okay, so what are the coordinates of point B? I am having is 4, 5. Now what about C? C is nothing but the intersection of x plus y is equals to 9 and 3x plus y equals to 21. Now solve for C, which is nothing but the intersection of 3x plus y equals to 21. 3x plus y equals to 21 and x plus y, it is equals to 9. Subtract the second equation from the first. So I'll be having 2x is equals to, so it is 21 minus 9 will be equals to 12. Okay, so 12 plus 9 is 21. So x is equals to how much? It is a 6. So if x is 6, so if we substitute it in the second equation, 6 plus y is equals to 9 implies y is equals to 3. Okay, so what are the point coordinate of a point P? I am getting is 6, 3. So let's write here 6, 3. Now get the objective function z is equals to 3x plus 5y. Z is equals to 3x plus 5y, and check the values at different points at A, B, C, D, at A, B, C, D, and at origin. So get the value of z. So A coordinates are nothing but 0, 6. So it's a 0 plus 30 equals to 30. The coordinate of B are nothing but 4, 5. So 4, 5 means what? 4 into 3 is 12, and 5 is nothing but 5 into 5 is 25. So 25 plus 12 is nothing but 37. Next we have the point C, which is 6, 3. So 6 means what? It is 6 into 3 is 18 plus 3, so 15. So 5 into 3 is 15. So 18 and 15, it is nothing but 8 plus 13 carry 1, so it becomes 33. At D, I will be having the coordinate as 6, 0. So 18 plus 0, which is nothing but 18. And at 0 origin, I will be having 0 plus 0, it is equals to 0. So what is your objective function? You want to maximize or minimize? I want to maximize it. So what is the maximum value here is 27. And what is the solution? The solution is nothing but the point B, which is nothing but 4, 5. So value of x is 4 and y is 5 to get the maximum value of z. So this is what I get the solution for this given LPP. Now let's take the the sixth question. So the sixth question says that we have to minimize the given LPP. Okay, so let's solve this. So this is the first question of minimization. Okay, so get the first step, which is nothing but step number one. Z is equals to 7x plus y, 5x plus y is greater than or equals to 5 and x plus y is greater than or equals to. Step number 2 is get the equations, write down the equations. So 5x plus y equals to 5 and x plus y it is equals to 3. Get the double intercept form. So x by 1 plus y by 5 it is equals to 1, x by 3 plus y by 3 it is equals to again 1. Get the coordinates and get the equation of lines plotted on the coordinate system. So it is having the 1, 5. So let's draw manually now. So this is what y axis, this is what I get the x axis. Okay, so it is 1, 5. So let's take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So it is 1 and it's a 5. So let's pass the line through these two points. So it is somewhat like this, 1, 5. And the second line is passing through the point 3 and 3. Okay. So this is how I get approximately 3 and 3. Now what is the solution set, individual solution set? So x, 5x plus y, let's substitute 0 plus 0. So 0 plus 0 is substitute if whether 0 is greater than or equals to 5. No, means what? Origin is not included for the first line. What about 0 plus 0 greater than or equals to 3? Again, origin is not included in the solution set. Matlab kya hai? Dono line ke feasible solution mein origin include nahi hai. Means what I get? For both the lines, the solution set is what? Above the lines. And this is what the common region for this. So this is how the common region is. Now I want to find out the minimum value. Just by observation, we can get the minimum value, which is here somewhere here, which lies the minimum value. So let's verify this. So take this point A, which is nothing but 0, 5 corner points. This point we have to calculate. This point B is nothing but 3, 0, and this is x axis and this is the y axis. Okay, and let's take this point as a C and let's find out the coordinates of point C. So this C is nothing but the intersection of the given two lines. So which is 5x plus y which is equals to 5 and x plus y which is equals to 3. Okay, if I subtract the second line from the first, I will be having 4x is equals to 5 minus 3 is 2. So x is equals to 2/4, which is nothing but 1/2. If x is equals to 1/2, what is the value of y? So y is equals to 3 minus 1/2, which number 6 minus 1 it is 5/2. So the coordinate of point C becomes 1/2 and 5/2. Okay, so this point P is nothing but 1/2, 5/2. Now let's have the values of z at these three corner points. So 7x plus y is the 7x plus y is our objective function. So at A, which is nothing but 0, 5, a 0, 5, which is nothing but 0, 0 plus 5, so value is 5. At B, which is nothing but 3, 0, so subtract 21 plus 0, which is nothing but 21. And at C, which is 1/2, 5/2, 1/2, 5/2, so this is nothing but 7 into 1/2 plus 5/2, which is nothing but 7 plus 5, which is 12/2, which is nothing but 6. So what is the you are looking for the minimum value of z. So at what point you are getting the minimum value of z? So at A point I am getting the minimum value of z, and the minimum value is the 5. So what is your answer for this question is that the objective function is getting satisfied at the value x is equals to 0 and y is equals to 5. Y is equals to 5 and the minimum value is nothing but 5. So this is what your final answer is. Okay, so I hope you are understanding this. Now let's take the 7th question. We'll be having the same approach here in the 7th question again. So as these are the just repetition of the questions, I'll be having the answers in a short time. Okay, so that we can cover the more questions in the coming videos. Okay, so in detail solutions I have already covered in the last video. If you have not understood any of the point, you can refer to the previous video. So let's take the step number 1. So z is equals to 8x plus 10y. Write down the constraints. 2x plus y greater than or equals to 7. 2x plus 3y greater than or equals to 15. Y is greater than or equals to 2 and there are non-negative constraints. Step number 2, write down the inequalities into the equation form. So 2x plus y equals to 7, 2x plus 3y equals to 15 and y is equals to 2. Get the double intercept form. So it is x upon 7 by 2 plus y by 7, it is equals to 1. So x by 15 by 2 plus y by 5, it is equals to 1 and y is equals to 2. So let's draw the figure now. Take this and check the coordinates of the lines. So let's have the x-axis and y-axis. So this is what we get, the y-axis. This is the x-axis. Okay. Now mark the points. So 7 by 2, which is nothing but 3.5 and 7. Okay, so let's take the x, that is a 7 by 2. So first of all, let me write down here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay, so the first line is having 7 by 2, which is 3.5. and 7, so 3.5 will be somewhere here and 7 is here. So let's draw the line which is passing through these two points. So this is how we get this equation, and let me correct this. Yes, so it is, the equation is what, 2x plus y is 2x plus y, it is equals to 7. Get the second equation, that is a 15 by 2 means what, it is a 7.5 and 5. So 7.5 will be somewhere here and 5 is here. Okay, let's draw the line passing through these two points. So this is how I get the second line. So the equation is 2x plus 3y equals to 15. 2x plus 3y equals to 15. And the third line is y is equals to 2, that is parallel to the x-axis. Y is equals to 2 matlab ye aisa flow ho jayega yahan se. So this is what I get, the y is equals to 2 point. Okay, great. Now we have to find out the minimum value of z. So our objective is to minimize the objective function. Okay, so find out the individual solution set and the common solution set. So substitute, simple method, substitute 0 and 0 and let's check whether it is getting satisfied. 0, 0, not satisfied, 0, not satisfied. Okay, so for all the lines, the individual solution set will lie above the lines. Okay, and in the common, if we discuss in the common feasible set, the solution set will be like this. Okay. So this will be the common solution set for the given LPP. Okay, so let's have, now let's have the corner points. So the first point A is nothing but 0, 7. This point we have to find out. This point is also we have to find out. So let's name this as point B, name this as a point C, B coordinates and C coordinates, and there is no point here, so this is nothing but y is equals to 2 line. Okay, so the C coordinate point we can easily find out. So like how, so C is nothing but the intersection of solve for C, which is nothing but the intersection of y is equals to 2 and this 2x plus 3y equals to 15. Okay, so 2x plus 3y is equals to, so let me substitute 2 here, which is equals to 15. So 2x plus 6 is equals to 15. So let's take that 6 on the opposite side. So this is nothing but 15 minus 6. So this is nothing but 2x is equals to 9. So x is will be 9 by 2. If x is equals to 9 by 2, what will be the value of? Okay, y is equals to 2. So here the point you are getting is nothing but, that is 9 by 2 comma 2. 9 by 2 comma 2 you are getting here. Okay, now solve for b. So b is nothing but the intersection of first two lines, that is a 2x plus y equals to 7, equal to 7, and 2x plus 3y, it is equals to 15. So ye minus minus and ye minus, so ye dono cancel ho gaye. So I'll be having minus 2y, it is equals to minus of 8. So y is equals to 8 by 2, ye ho gaya apna 4. So if it is 4, so let's substitute in the first equation. So 2x plus 4 equals to 7. So 2x will be equals to 7 minus 4, which is equals to 3. So x is equals to 3 by 2, which is nothing but 1.5. So what is the coordinate of a point B you are getting is the 3 by 2 comma 4 you are getting. Okay, so let me write that 3 by 2 comma 4. Okay, so once you have these points with you, you can find out the minimum value of z. Okay, so let's have the z, which is nothing but 8x plus 10y, and you want to find out its minimum value. So at a b c, a is 0, 7, a 0, 7, at b, which is nothing but 3 by 2 comma 4, at c, which is nothing but 9 by 2 comma 2. So here you will be having z value, which is nothing but 70. Here I will be having z value, which is 8 into 3 by 2 plus 10 into 4, which is nothing but 40. Ye gaya 4 pe, so ye gaya 4 trikam 12, and ye bechay, so it will be equals to 52. And here I will be having z is equals to 8 into 9 by 2 plus 10 into 2 is 20. So ye aagya apna 4, no chok 36. 46 ani hai 56. Okay, so what is the minimum value you are getting is 52, and the solution for this is nothing but x is equals to 3 by 2 and y is equals to 4. So this is what the solution for the given linear programming problem. Okay, so the minimum value of z is 52 and the solution is x is equals to 3 by 2 and y is equals to 4. I hope you have understood this question as well. Okay, so let's take the last question of this video, of this exercise as a homework. You all solve this question, you take this question as a homework question. So let me check. So it is very, very simple. It is totally depending on the 6 and 7. In this same way, you can solve this question. Okay, take this question as a homework and submit it to me. Okay, if you have any doubt at any point of time, you can ask me your doubts. We'll try to cover your doubt as early as possible. Okay, so with this, we will stop here in this video, and let's meet in the next class. Thank you.